Hi guys, welcome back to Digital Lab. Last month, Huawei released the P60 series smartphone, and there is a pretty special 88W charger inside the box. It's equipped with a USB-C and a USB-A port, but you cannot charge two devices at the same time. Let's take a look at how it works. It can support up to 88W and Huawei Supercharge. We'll talk about the specs info later. Open the box. Except for the charger itself, it also comes with a charging cable. The 6A means it supports up to 6A. And the orange USB-C connector is not a full pin design. The ChargeLab Ho ZKM003C shows this cable integrates an eMarker chip, but it only supports USB 2.0. And the length of this cable is about 1 meter. The slide hollows on two sides can facilitate the user to pull it out or plug it in. And the input prongs cannot be folded. All specs info are printed under the input prongs. It supports input of 120V, 50 or 60 2.4A. Both USB-A and USB-C can support up to 20V, 4.4A. That's 88W. Next, we can see that the USB-C and USB-A are side by side, no gaps between them. The size of this charger is about 50x50x28mm. Compared with Apple 96W charger, it's much smaller, and the weight is about 105 grams. The ChargeLab Power ZKM003C shows the USB-C supports UFCS 88W, FCP, SCP, QC 2.0, PD 3.0, PPS, QC5, and DCP protocols. And it also supports 5 fixed videos of 5V, 9V, 12V, 15V 3A, 20V 3.25A, and a set of PPS. The USB-A also supports UFCS 88W, FCP, SCP, QC 2.0, and DCP protocols. Use it to charge the iQOO 10 Pro. The real-time power is about 23W, and the protocol is UFCS. Next, let's cut off the plastic case using the cutting machine. There is a circle of film around two USB ports. The input end of the PCBA module is filled with potting compound, and the module is covered with a brass heatsink. Let's clean up the module and remove the heatsink. ChargeLab found it adopts a planar transformer to make the charger smaller, and the groove can isolate the primary and secondary sides. Let's introduce all components one by one. The input time delay fuse is from Better Electronics, 2.5A, 250V. The blue varistor is from STE for input surge protection, wrapped with heat shrinkable tubing. And the green NTC Thermistor is also from STE, used to suppress the surge current. The common mode choke is also insulated by heat shrinkable tubing. The bridge rectifier is from Pingwei, 8A, 1000V. Those three electrolytic capacitors are from AiSHi HS series, 400V, 27μF for each. Another electrolytic capacitor is 400V, 60μF. The differential mode choke is next to the common mode choke and bridge rectifier, insulated with heat shrinkable tubing. Here is the primary controller, marked with JW1561. A MOSFET is next to it. The primary MOSFET is from Silan, which adopts TO220F package, 650V, 260mΩ. This thin capacitor can power the primary controller, 63V, 10μF. As mentioned, the planar transformer is soldered on the side. Here is the synchronous rectification controller soldered on the PCB of the planar transformer. The synchronous rectifier is also from Silan and adopts PDFN-A-5x6 package, 100 volts, 7 milliohm. Another same MOSFET is on the opposite side. The safety Y capacitor is from Fenghua CD7 series, is connected in series and adopts a rare yellow resin package. The optocoupler is used to regulate the output voltage through the protocol chip. Those two solid capacitors for output filtering are 560 microfarad, 25 volts. Another smaller one is 430 microfarad, 25 volts. The protocol chip is from Convenient Power. It can support USB PD 3.0, PPS, UFCS, etc. Those two VBUS MOSFETs are used to control the USB-A and USB-C port, respectively. Even if you insert two cables into two USB ports, only one will work. Those two connectors are so close, it's almost impossible to use them at the same time. Well, that's all components of this Huawei 88W dual port charger. It can support 88W proprietary protocol and 65W PD protocol, so it can be regarded as your phone charger or laptop power adapter. After taking it apart, we found the internal structure is quite neat and compact. Not only does the physical port limit the simultaneous charging of two devices, but the internal chip design also determines that this is absolutely impossible. Okay, that's all for today's video. Please drop a like, leave your comments, and subscribe to us. I'll catch you guys in the next video. Bye!